Hello there everyone, you are listening to Jasbir Kaur and today we are going to start with our revision for PA1. So the topics which we are going to include is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, few word problems and also Roman numerals, right? So let's start with addition first of all. So over here you can see four numbers given over here for this question. You have to add all these four numbers. So first of all you will write 4, 5, 6, 3, 8, 9, which is our first value. Then when you are writing the second number, you always have to start writing from the ones place. So ones place is 7, then tens place is 8, that is 7, 8, then 9, 3, 6. Again for the third number, always start writing from the ones place, 5, 4, 9, 8, 7. Then fourth number is 2356. So 6, 5, 3, 2. Like that you have to always start writing from the ones place. If you'll write like this, your answer would always be correct. Sometimes what happens, you start writing from the left hand side and this place is empty. So what will happen? Your answer will be incorrect. Right, so to avoid that, you always have to start writing from the right hand side. That means ones place you always have to start writing with. So let me erase this. So over here will be adding the numbers. 9 plus 7 is 16, 16 plus 5 21, 21 plus 6 27. So 2 carried over here, then 7 over here, then 2 plus 8 is 10, 10 plus 8 18, 18 plus 4 22, 22 plus 5 27. So again 2 is carried over here, then 7 over here, then 2 plus 3 5, 5 plus 9 14, 14 plus 9 is 23, 23 plus 3 is 26, right? So 2 carried over here and 6 over here. This way you have to go on adding the number to get this answer. Now let's proceed with subtraction, right? So over here you can see that 4562, subtract 4562 from 5632. So first of all you have to understand the question, what you have to subtract from what. So 4562 is to be subtracted from 5632, right? So 5632 you have to write, and then you have to write 4562 over here. You have to subtract this, right? So 2 minus 2 0, 3 minus 6 is not possible. Okay, so we'll make this 13. So where do we take this 1 from? We'll take this 1 from 6. So 6 will become 5 and 3 will become 13. So 13 minus 6 is 7, 5 minus 5 is 0 and 5 minus 4 is 1. So 1070 is our answer. Then next question is 5632 is to be subtracted from 78965. So you'll be writing 578. Okay, my question is wrong over here. So let's just write 7805. Okay, so this is incorrect. So we have to minus 5632 from 78005. So 5 minus 2 is 3, then 0 minus 3 is not possible. So we'll make this 10 and this 0 will become 9 as we took 1 from this 8. So this 8 will become 9. So 10 minus 3 is 7, 9 minus 6 is 3, 7 minus 5 is 2, and then we have to write 7. Then next is multiplication. Now in multiplication you have to be very careful that which number you are multiplying with what. So first of all we'll be multiplying this 5 with each of this digit. So 5 5 is 25, 2 carried over here, 5 over here, 5 6 are 30 plus 2 32, so 3 carried, 2 over here, then 5 3s are 15 plus 3 18, so 1 carried, 8 over here, 5 2s are 10 plus 1 11, so we wrote 11 over here. Similarly, we'll multiply this 3 with all these digits. So 3 5s are 15, 1 carried, 5 over here. You have to put cross when you are multiplying with the second number, na? At that time you have to put one cross over here, or you can put 0 also over here, it will be fine. It's up to you what you want to write, whether x you want to put or whether 0. So 3 5s are 15, 1 carried over here, 5 over here. 3 6 are 18 plus 1 19, 1 over here, 9 over here. Then 3 3s are 9 plus 1 10, so 1 carried over here and 0 over here. 3 2s are 6 plus 1 7, okay, you have written 7. Then similarly, we have to multiply the hundreds place, which is over here. 2 Faiza is 10, 1 carried over here, 0 over here. When you are multiplying the third number now with this number, you have to put 2 cross or 2 zeros over here. So 2 Faiza is 10, 1 carried over here, 0 over here. 2 6 are 12 plus 1 13, 1 over here, 3 over here. 2 3 are 6 plus 1 7. 2 2s are 4, so we have written 4. Then you have to add all these values, so we'll get 5. Then 5 plus 2 is 7, 9 plus 8 is 17, so 1 carried over here, 7 over here. 3 plus 1 4 plus 1 5, so 5 over here. Then 7 plus 7 14 plus 1 15, so 1 carried, 5 over here, 4 plus 1 5. So this way you have to do multiplication. Similarly for this question also, you have to do the multiplication. Now let's proceed with the division sums. Now you over here you can see 5 6 3 9 is to be divided by 13. So let's do this. 5 6 3 9 is to be divided by 13. So 13 4s are, will write 52, right? So we'll do the subtraction, we'll get 4. Then we'll bring down this 3 over here. So 13, then number 13 3s are, right? 13 3s are is 39. Again we'll do the subtraction. 3 minus 9 is not possible, we'll make this 13, and this will become 3. So 13 minus 9 is 4. Then we'll bring down this 9 over here. So again we'll be multiplying 13 by 3. 13 3s are is 39. We'll get the remainder as 10. Okay, so we'll get the remainder as 10. Now how we are going to check? You know, there was a question in 1D that you have to check your answer whether it is right or wrong. So what is the method to check? Divisor is to be multiplied by quotient, and then in that you have to add the remainder. This was the method to check. Then if you'll get this dividend, then your answer is correct. Otherwise your answer is incorrect. So what is the divisor? Divisor is 13, and our quotient is 4, 3, 3. And then you have to add the remainder, which we got as 10. So let's multiply this over here. 4, 3, 3, multiply by 13. Okay. Don't go on my handwriting because I'm trying to write using my keypad. So it happens. 3 3s are is 9, then 3 3s are again 9, 4 3 4s are is 12, then you have to put cross as you are going to multiply with the second number, which is on tens place. So 1 3s are is 3, then 3, 1 multiplied by any number, we'll get the same answer, sorry. So we'll get 9. What do we get? 9. Then we'll get 1 over here, 2 over here, and 6 over here and 5 over here. So we got 5 for this 2. We got 5, 6, 2, 9. 5, 6, 2, 9. And when we'll add 10 in this, we'll get the dividend, which is 5, 6, 3, 9. Okay. So we got 5, 6, 3, and 9. Right. So we got this dividend. So our answer is correct. So our quotient is correct. Right. Similarly, you have to do for question number 2. Now let's proceed with question number 6. This is your textual question, which is in your textbook, chapter number 1. Counting by 5, write the numbers from 8723 to 8743. So you have to go on adding 5 till you get this number. Counting by 5 means you have to go on counting 5 till you get this number. Right, so when we added 5 in 8723, we got 8728. Then again you have to write down this number. Again you have to add 5, you'll get 8733. Then again you have to write down 8733 over here. Add 5, you'll get 8738. Then again you have to write this 8738 over here. For the next answer, 8738 plus 5 will get 8748. So we got this number, you have to stop over here. So now you have to write all these numbers: 8723 8728 8733 8738 and 8743, which is our last number. Now similarly for question number B also, you have to do like this: go on adding 5 till you get this number. You can see over here, you can pause the video and you can write also. If you have not completed, you can write also. You have to go on adding 5 till you get this 81014. So we got 80989, then 80994 till 81014, right? Now let's do another question over here. So many students had the problem in this question, as they didn't understood what you have to do in this. The question is, what is the difference between the place values of 2 7s? Place value of 2 7, that means 1 7 is over here and second 7 is over here. You have to first of all find out the place value of 2 7. So first 7's place value is 70,000 and second 7's place value is 70. Now you have to find out the difference. Difference means subtraction. What does that mean? Difference means subtraction. So what you have to do, you have to subtract 70 from 70,000. So what do we get over here? 69,930. So this is the difference which we got. Now question number 2 is 2 8s. Find the difference between the place values of 2 8s. So first 8 is over here and second 8 is over here. First 8's value is 8 lakh and second 8's value is 8,000. Now 8 lakh minus 8,000, we got 77,92,000. This is our difference. This way you have to find out the difference between the place value. First of all, you have to find out the place value, then you have to subtract the smaller value from the greater one. Now we'll do question number 11. Write the numeral for the greatest and the smallest possible number made from each of the following groups. So using this number, we'll be making one smallest number and one greatest number. One thing which you have to be very sure with is that you always have to write the zero on the second place whenever you are writing the smallest number. You look for the smaller number rather than zero. Zero you have to write on the second place. So first of all, you will write 3, then you will write 0 on the second place, then in ascending order you will write 4 7 9, right? For the smallest number, we always have to see for the smallest number leaving 0, then you have to apply 0. You have to note this. Now greatest, for greatest you always have to write 0 at the last place. Whenever there is 0 in the given digits, you always have to write 0 at the last place, right? For the smallest, you always have to write on the second place. So for the greatest, you will write in descending order 9 7 4 3 and then 0. Similarly for question number B, we'll write 2 first, then 0, then 3, 6, 7, 8. For the greatest, 0 is at the last place. 8, 7, 6, 3, 2, 0. This way you have to write down the smallest possible number and the greatest possible number. Now let's see one word problem over here. The word problem is for a primary health center, 28,680 were given in the first year. What was given in the first year? First year, this much amount was given for the primary health center. In the second year, 5,850 more than the first year were given. More than the first year, that means you have to add 5,850 in 28,680. You'll get the amount given in the second year. Now, next statement is, in the third year, 4,700 more than the amount given in the second year were given. More than the amount in the second. So what is the amount of second year? The amount of second year is 34,530. So you have to add 4,700 in this 34,530. You will get 39,230. Now you have to find out what was the total amount given to the center in 3 years. That means addition. Total amount given in 3 years is equal to 28,680. Then 34,530 and 39,230. You'll get 1,02,440. Therefore, the total amount given to the center in 3 years was 1,02,440. Okay. Then we'll proceed with question number 5. This is also a textual question. You can see in your textbook. What must be added to 16,003? To make it equal to 1,25,000. See, if I give you what must be added to 3 to make it equal to 5, what I should add in 3, what I should add in 3 to make it equal to 5. So what I will do, 5 minus 3, what I'll do, 5 minus 3, I'll get 2. So 2 must be added to 3 to make it equal to 5, right? I should add 3, I should add 2 in that to make it equal to 5. Similarly, in this question, what you have to do, you have to subtract, what you have to do, you have to subtract 16,003 from 1,25,000 to get the answer, right? So what must be added? 1,08,997 is to be added to 16,003 to make it equal to 1,25,000. So the answer is 1,08,997. Now our next question, next word problem is, Geeta deposited 30,000 in her bank account. Okay, suppose today Geeta deposited 30,000 in her bank account. On the next day or day tomorrow, she has withdrawn 18,237 from it. That means she has taken out 18,237. So what we are going to do, what we have to find out over here, how much money is there in her account now? We have to find out that. So what we are going to do, money deposited minus money withdrawn. We'll be getting the answer. 30,000 minus 18,237 is 11,763. So how much amount Geeta is having in her account? Geeta is having 11,763 rupees in her account. This way you have to do subtraction. Money deposited means first day she has deposited money. The next day or day after tomorrow she has withdrawn the amount, and what amount is there in her account, that we have to find out. So for that we'll be doing subtraction. Now let's proceed with another example over here, another word problem over here. A sweet shop received the following amount of money on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday respectively. So this is the amount which the sweet shop has received. What we have to do, what was the total sale of the shop in those 4 days? So we just have to add all the values given over here. Money received on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. We have to add this. We got 7,454.72. Therefore, the total sale of the shop in 4 days was 7,454.72 rupees. All right. Now, question number 5. What is question number 5? A factory produces. This one is also your word problem in your chapter number 1. A factory produces 470 toy cars a day. How many cars did it produce in the year 1988 if there were 86 holidays in that year? So first of all, if the year is given to you, you have to find out how many days were there in that year, whether it was 366 days or 365 days. Generally, in a non-leap year, in a non-leap year, we have 365 days, but in a leap year, we have 366 days. So first thing which you have to do is, you have to divide that particular year by 4. If you get the remainder 0, then that year was a leap year. So when we have divided this number by 4, we got the remainder 0. So this year was a leap year. We got that. Now, as that 1988 was a leap year, so it had 366 days. So now in this question, if there were 86 holidays is written, so we have to subtract 86 from the number of days. 366 minus 86, we got 280. So number of working days, we got 280. Now we know that in one day 470 toy cars are produced. We have to find out in 280 days how many toy cars were produced. So we'll multiply 470 by 280. So we got 131,600. Therefore, number of toys produced in the year 1988 was 131,600. This way you have to find out. Now let's proceed with question number 6. Word problem. A factory packs 144 ball pens in a carton. How many ball pens are packed in one carton? 144. In one carton, 144 ball pens are packed. So we have to find out if they have 395 cartons to be filled. They have already made 57,000 ball pens. Do they need to make more ball pens in order to fill all the cartons? If yes, how many more ball pens are to be made? Else find out how many extra ball pens are lying in the factory. So we know that in one carton we'll be filling 144 pens. We have to find out in 395 cartons how many ball pens are to be filled. So when we multiplied, we got 56,880. So we know that which is less than 57,000. So we came to know that we don't need to make any more ball pens to fill the cartons. So pens to be filled in 395 cartons is 56,880. So we know that extra ball pens are lying in the factory. So extra ball pens lying in the factory is equal to 57,000 minus 56,880. We got 120. So there is no need to make more ball pens because 120 extra ball pens are lying in the factory. This way you have to find out this. Now let's proceed with Roman numerals. This is your third chapter in your book. So first of all, this is the standard table which you have to memorize, right? You have to memorize. I'll give you the trick also how you have to find out, how you have to write the Roman numerals. So first standard table is this. First standard table is this. I, you have to write for 1. V, you have to write for 5. X, you have to write for 10. L, you have to write for 50. C, you have to write for 100. D, you have to write for 500. And M, you have to write for 1000. Right? So, from 1 to 9, it is given over here. I for 1. I for 2. 3 times I for 3. Similarly, the main thing which you have to learn is 4, 9. Right? How you have to write 4? 4 means 5 minus 1 is 4. So you will write 5, that means V, minus 1. 1 means I. So IV means 4. Now 5, you know that you write V for 5. Now 6, how you have to write 6? 6 means 5 plus 1. So 5 means V plus 1 means I. Right? When you are writing the smaller number to the right hand side, smaller number to the right hand side, that means addition. When you are writing the smaller number to the left hand side, that means subtraction. You have to know this, that means subtraction. Let me teach you over here. Whenever a Roman numeral, you can see over here, whenever a Roman numeral is repeated or smaller Roman numeral follows a larger number, the values are added together. See over here, this 5 is followed by this smaller number, right, which is 3. I means 3. So this larger number is followed by this smaller number. So that means addition, right? When this is clear. Now whenever a smaller Roman numeral appears before the larger Roman numeral, appears before the larger, this one is smaller, I is smaller than x means 10. So whenever the smaller number or smaller Roman numeral is written before the larger Roman numeral, that means subtraction. So x means 10 minus 1 means 9. 10 minus 1 means 9. So 1 is subtracted from 10, that means it is 9. So ix means 9. Now let's proceed with the addition rule. We have learnt addition also and subtraction also. So let's see first of all addition. In addition, you can see x means 10, right? I means 1. So 10 plus 1 is 11. So you write 11 like this. Now x means 10 and b means 5. So 10 plus 5 is 15. So you'll write 15 like this, xv. Now c means 100, v means 5 plus 2, 7. So this is 7 and this is 100. So 107 you write like this. Now D means 500, C means 100, 100 and 100. So 5 plus 100, 600, then 700, then 800. Now L means 50 and X means 10. So 50 plus 10 is 60. So 860 you write in Roman numeral like this. Now let's proceed with subtraction rule. There are some rules about subtraction. I, X and C are the only Roman numerals that can be subtracted. Now, let's talk about I. I can only be subtracted from V and X. You have seen that for 4, what do we write? How do we write 4? 4 we write like IV. So we have subtracted I, that means V means 5 and I means 1. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So we write 4 like this. Now we'll see, it is also written that I can also be subtracted from X. X means 10. If we'll subtract I from X, it will become 9. So IX means 9. Now second point is X can only be subtracted from L and C. X can only be subtracted from L and C. What does that mean? If I'll subtract X from L, let's do this. I've written L, and if I subtract X from L, I have to write X on the left hand side, right? XL means, what does that mean? It means 40. Okay. Now, let me subtract X from C. I'll write C over here. C means 100 and X means 10. Right, 100 minus 10 is 90. So XC means 90. What does that mean? XC means 90. Now let's do this rule number 3, which is C can only be subtracted from D and M. C can only be subtracted from D and M. Let's write D first of all, then let's write C on the left hand. D means 500 and C means 100. So CD means 400. CD means 400. Now let's write M. Now it is written that C can only be subtracted from D and M. So we'll write M over here and C on the left hand side. So CM means over here. M means 1000 and C means 100. So 1000 minus 100 is 900. 1000 minus 100 is 900. Okay, I think you are clear with this now. Now let's see Roman numeral subtractive rule over here. 4. How do we write 4? 5 minus 1. So 5 means V and 1 means I. So IV means 4. Then 9 over here. X means 10 and I means 1. So 10 minus 1, 9. Now how do we write 40? L on the right hand side, X on the left hand side. XL means 40. 90. C means 100 and X means 10. So XC means 90. How do we write 40? 400? CD. CD means 400. D means 500 and C means 100. 500 minus 100. Is 400. Now 900. How do we write 900 over here? M minus C. That means M means 1000 and C means 100. So M 1000 minus 100 is 900. Okay. Now let's see this Roman numeral chart over here. Here you can see from 1 to 100. All these Roman numerals are written. You can pause the video and you can write down. You can get on Google also. If you search Roman numerals table, you'll get this also. But if you want to write, you can pause the video and you can write also. Right? It will be very easier for you to write them. Now let's see few more examples over here. We know that how do we write 1, right? 1 we'll write I, 2 we write 2 times I, then 3 we write 3 times I. We knew that how do we write 4, IV means 4, V means 5, 5 minus 1, that means 5 minus 1 is 4, so IV we write for 4, and then V we write for 5, and VI, that means 5 plus 1, 6, we write VI, then for 7 we write VII, that means 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1, 7, so VII. For 8 we write V 5 6 7 8. Then for 9, how do we write 9? 10 minus 1. What is it? 10 minus 1, that means X means 10. And 1 you will write. For 1 numeral you will write Roman on the left hand side. So X means 10 and I means 1. So IX means 9. Now 10 you know which is X. Then 20, 2 times X, 30, 3 times X, 10 plus 10 plus 10, that is X, X, X. Then 40, for 40 what you will do, you will subtract 10 from 50, 50 minus 10, that means 50 you will write on the right hand side and 10 you will write on the left hand side. Now L you know which is 50, then 60, how you will write 60, L means 50, L and then X, X means 10. So 50 plus 10, that is 60. Then 50 plus 10, 60 plus 10, 70. Then for 80, 50, then 60, 70 and 80. Now let's come to 90. How do we write 90? 90 means C. What is C? C means 100 and X means 10. So XC means 900. XC means 90. 100 minus 10 is 90. Now let's see D over here. D means 500, right? D means 500 and M means 1000 over here. Now how we are going to write 105? So 100 means C and 5 means V. So CV means 105. Then 1080. So 1000, how do you write 1000? For 1000 we write M. For 1000 we write M, right? So we'll write M. For 80. 80, what is 80 over here? 80 means 50 plus 10, 60 plus 10, 70 plus 10, 80. So M L triple X. Then X 550. So 550 you'll read like this, 500. So 500 you'll write D and then 50. How do you read this? 550. 500 means D and 50 means L. Then you'll read this 456. then you will write 400, then 50 means L. 400, how do you write 400? 400 means CD. That means 500 minus 100, right? So CD, then 50. 50 means L and 6 means VI. So CDLVI is for 456. Now 690. So 600 you will write, that means 500 plus 100, that is 600. DC means 600. And how do you write 90? 90 means 100 minus 10, that is XC. So DCXC is for 690. Similarly, for 985, so you will write 900 plus 80 and then plus 5. So 900, how do you write 900? 900 means M means 1000 minus C. 1000 minus C, that means C means 100. So CM means 900, 80 means 50, 60, 70 and 80. L, X, X, X means 80. Then we'll write 5. Similarly, you have to do for all these questions. I hope you would have understood how you have to write for Roman numerals, how you have to solve the sums, word problems. That's it for today. We'll meet again in the next video. We are already doing the sums in our Zoom classes. So if any query you people are having, you can share with us. We'll sort out your problem. All the maths teachers. Thank you. That's it for today. Thank you all.